Startling new developments tonight in the arson fire that destroyed the landmark Hereford House restaurant. Owner Rod Anderson has been indicted by a federal grand jury and now faces 55 years in prison if convicted. KMBC 9's Peggy Bright begins our team coverage live at the federal courthouse downtown. Peggy?
Larry, the indictment accuses Anderson of planning the arson while others carried it out. The fire broke out on October 20th, 2008, and was immediately suspected to be arson. Now investigators say Anderson met with co-conspirators about a month before that in his restaurant and gave them keys and a security code for the alarm system. That first meeting lasted almost an hour and included a tour of the restaurant. Then there was allegedly a dry run 8 days before the fire. All done, the indictment says, for insurance money.
The indictment alleges that after the fire, Anderson submitted a false claim to his insurance company representing that he had no involvement in setting the fire. He claimed nearly $2.5 million in losses.
Investigators are still actively looking into this case and want you to look closely at these two pictures. The men in these photographs believed to be conspirators who, as of yet, are unnamed. So right now, only Rod Anderson is charged in this case, and he turned himself in this afternoon. Martin Augustine was in court for those proceedings. Martin?
Yeah, Peggy, Rod Anderson was in court at exactly the same time that the U.S. attorney was announcing those charges against him, and he'll be allowed to walk away from court tonight without posting any bond. Now, while in court this afternoon, Anderson pleaded not guilty to all the charges. He surrendered to the court shortly after the grand jury indicted him, as Peggy reported, and that cooperation, along with several reasons we'll talk about in a moment, will allow him to go home tonight once federal authorities have formally booked him. Now, given the dangerous nature of the charges against him in connection to the fire, prosecutors wanted Anderson held in jail and he wanted him to have to post bond, but the judge decided against that because, in her opinion, Anderson had too many connections to Kansas City, and that would make him unlikely to skip out on any future court appearances.
The conditions include, you know, family ties, community ties, a lack of a criminal record, a lack of substance abuse issue. All of those are set out in the federal statute.
Now, Hobbs also says that Anderson, who was joined by his wife in court today, did not want to talk about any of the charges against him. Reporting live, Martin Augustine, KMBC 9 News.